Namaste viewers, welcome to Jnana Degula channel. In this episode, we will see the role of Karna in this Mahabharata war, Kurukshetra war. We have been seeing his lot of, in 3-4 episodes we have seen his birth, where he was born, and then where he was brought up, his learning of warfare skills, all those things we have dealt with. Now we will see what was his role in the Mahabharata war, Kurukshetra war. In this epic battle, great battle of Kurukshetra, this happened in the Kurukshetra, field of Kurukshetra there. Now, even to this day, it is present near Delhi, New Delhi. Karna stood, he was a most formidable warriors on the battlefield. It was very difficult to defeat him or control him. That was the kind of a warriorship he had. He was born with divine gifts from his father, that is Surya. His father had given him Karna Kundala. He had given him some armors, golden plated arm, breast plates, radiant earrings, all those things, you know, which covered his body, the entire body it covered, so that no astra, this thing could pierce that and then hurt him. Just as now we have this bulletproof jackets, you know, where bullets cannot enter and then hurt you. Those days, this breastplates and other arm plates, then knee plates, all those kinds of things were being worn so that they could resist, they could stop the attack by fords or the attack by javelins and things like that, you know. Like that it could stop them and then it won't hurt them. But this Surya had given him, provided him at a boron kavcha itself. It was almost inbuilt, like, you know, thing which was inbuilt in the body, that kind of a armory it was. So all these things made him virtually immortal. But his journey through this war was not just about strength and valor. It is not just about strength and valor, but also about like sacrifice, loyalty, commitment to these principles. So many things were there. Now the war begins between Pandavas and Kauravas. The war is every day, it is intensifying. Very ferociously both have been fighting. Slowly Karna's turn also comes, you know, where he heads the army and the entire thing. So now he starts fighting with very ferociously for the on the Kaurava side. Now this Kunti, mother Kunti, knowing that he was born with some kind of a divine protection, his mother Kunti and other Pandavas, all these, this other son of us, Bhishma, Dharmaraya, Nakula, Sahadeva, Arjuna, Bhima, all those people, you know, they were all, not Bhishma, Bhima, all those people, they were worried. They feared that the inevitable clash between Karna and his Arjuna would be very intense. So the gods themselves, including Indra, Indra was the father of Arjuna. Incidentally, Kunti had, there's another story for Arjuna's birth. So Kunti had invoked Indra and then she got a baby that was named after, named as Arjuna. Now Indra was worried that his son would be killed. So he conspired to strip Karna of his invincibility. So this Vajrakavacha and all those things. Now this Surya knew that this fellow would come and then do something. He had warned the Surya, the sun god, you know, the father of Karna, had warned him that there is some kind of a danger to you. He also revealed that Indra would come in the form of a Brahmin and request Karna's request Karna to give his armor and earrings, all those kinds of things. And once he gives up, giving these up would make Karna immortal. He would die. But the unwavering warrior chose to uphold his reputation. He never wanted to go back on his words, go back on his principles, go back on his dharma. Even at the cost of his life, even he would never mind dying also. But he wanted to keep up his reputation. That is why even to this day, Karna is being is a big hero today. He believed that his fame as a giver of charity was more valuable than his own living or immortality. We call him Dana Veera Shura Karna. That is the title which is given to him. So this is his, that was his nature. He wanted that fame rather than his life there. So now Indra, as usual, he appears as predicted by Surya. He comes in the form of a Brahmin. And then he talks to Karna. Karna did not hesitate. He asks Karna. So in a particular moment he comes and then he says, I want something from you. Will you be able to give it? And he says, yes, whatever you ask, I will give you. That's all. There's no second thought about it. Now Indra says, I want your Karna Kundala, the Kavachas, all those things I want. They're all inbuilt. They are built to this chest, earrings, all those things, you know, which cover the body and then which protect them. Even 24/7, it will be there with him. This our Indra is asking, just give me, in the guise of a Brahmin. Karna says, yes, I will give. He took a sharp knife. With his own hands, he removes this kavachas. He removes his Karna Kundala, removes, cuts everything, and then just hands it over to Indra. Blood is oozing out from his body. He never cares for that. But he was very satisfied that he has given the Brahmin, he has given this person who has asked, whatever he had asked, you know, he has given him. He felt only satisfaction. He handed over these gifts to Indra, who was moved by his selflessness. So, it's not that easy. Maybe you may be interested in your son Arjuna, but when somebody is so generous and then gives away, he was moved too much. Then he granted him a very powerful weapon. In return, Indra gives him. He gives a celestial missile. And he says, this can kill anybody. Mortal, immortal, there is no question of this thing in front of this weapon. It will remove, it will kill anybody, he says. But one condition is that it should be used only once. You use that, it will kill that person. That's all. So that way he just gives him, he blesses him with this and then goes away. As the war raged on and continues, Karna kept the missile in reserve. He says, okay, I will use it against Arjuna. Waiting for a right moment to strike down Arjuna. Somewhere on the 13th day, the battle goes on. Both sides had suffered immense losses. Lot of lives have been lost. Lot of kings, soldiers, brothers, all of them they have died. And the conflict has become increasingly brutal. There's a very brutal this thing is going on. On the 14th day was particularly very vicious day. Arjuna sought vengeance for the death of his son, because Arjuna's son was, while Bhima and his son Ghatotkaja unleashed havoc on the Kaurava forces, Arjuna sought vengeance for that. Ghatotkaja, with his Rakshasa lineage, this demon-like lineage, you know, wielded powers of illusion. So Maya Vidya, Maya Yuddha, where they would be stationed somewhere and then the missiles would be fired somewhere else, and then the enemies would be confused that way. This Maya Yuddha struck fear into the hearts of his enemies. Oh, everybody were fearful. Kaurava side, they were, it was very intense. And his abilities became more and more stronger as the battle stretched into the night, because Maya Vidya is very powerful during evenings, during the late hours. The Kaurava army led by Duryodhana and Karna was on the brink of collapse. It was almost, Ghatotkaja was, he could not be controlled at all. So it was almost on the brink of collapse. Desperately, you know, this Duryodhana pleaded with Karna. He said, he told him, use that divine weapon to save them. Indra has given you a beautiful weapon. You just use that, a deadly weapon. This fellow is not controllable. You just kill him. Karna knew that using the missile on Ghatotkaja would leave him without a weapon to defeat Arjuna. This was, he had kept this as a reserve to use it upon Arjuna. But what to do? The cries of his comrades and his sense of duty towards Duryodhana compelled him to use this. He took out this missile, launched the powerful missile, and with a brilliant flash, it struck down Ghatotkaja, bringing an end to the Rakshasa's rampage. Straight away, it killed Ghatotkaja. The Kaurava army rejoiced at their temporary victory, celebrating the death of Bhima's mighty son, Ghatotkaja. It was a very mighty power. But Karna knew the cost of his success, the cost of his triumph. His advantage over Arjuna was gone. The only one weapon that could have ensured his victory in their final confrontation had been spent, had been used already. So this was the fate of Karna. So Karna's role in the Kurukshetra war was marked by many of the heroic deeds and many a times, you know, heart-wrenching choices. He had no other choice. His sacrifice of divine gifts for the sake of his reputation, his loyalty to Duryodhana, and his relentless courage in the face of certain circumstances. All these things, you know, painted the portrait of a tragic hero here. He became a very tragic life, a tragic hero. Even in the chaos of war, the great confusion, great commotion, Karna remained calm, Karna remained true to his values. He earned his respect and admiration of both from his side and the enemy side also. They were appreciative of Karna's dharma nirata, or his righteousness, or his sticking to his principles. Viewers, here we end Karna's role in the Mahabharata war, his role in the Kurukshetra war. It is quite interesting. So we request you now to please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Please listen to this story. Thank you.